Well, I'm definitely honored to be here today and quite excited. And I can't believe it's been a year since Dave and I came up to accept our awards. So tonight I'm going to tell you a secret. Actually, two secrets, maybe. The first one is I was really nervous about coming up here tonight. And it's not about talking in front of a crowd, that's okay, I can do that. And I can talk business and sun tricks, talk your ear off, it's not an issue. But I really wanted to be able to provide some value to all of you. It's such an esteemed audience, and that made me nervous. So I decided to tell you a story about an accidental entrepreneur. So here goes. I'm a librarian by trade, which is just one of the best professions that I've ever experienced, and a really good place to find very strong female role models as well. I learned a lot working in and with libraries. I was happy with my career path, and I never ever thought about starting my own business. I come from a family business, and I am very well aware about the sacrifices and the hard work involved from business owners and their families. And while I've never been afraid of hard work, having my own company was nothing that I really aspired to. So it wasn't until I was in my early 30s with Dave and we had little Violet, who was a few months old, that we recognised an opportunity and we ran with it. So we were looking for solar for ourselves and found that we couldn't afford it. We had trouble finding a knowledgeable company to talk to. So we got the products ourselves, got it installed. And then we realised there were a lot of other people out there exactly like us who wanted to make a difference, who were looking for a knowledgeable, honest company to do business with. And so we found that gap in the market and we ran with it. And that's how Suntrix was born. We started small. We were both working part-time in our real jobs. And we had Violet at home on the days that we ended up calling the Suntrix days. And I would do all of the admin and the phone calls, and Dave, with his knowledge and his passion, would go out and visit the people at their home and sell the systems. I had no business background at all. I didn't even know how to write a proper tax invoice, let alone write terms of trade and find out how to purchase products from overseas, hire staff, and all those other things that we actually learnt from scratch. We literally started the business from our kitchen table, and 5 years later, we have over 20 staff and a multi-million dollar company. And if you haven't figured it out, the accidental entrepreneur is me. So we still have challenges every day, but they're very different to when we first started the business and really just building that business and trying to keep up. So I remember the risk of giving up our real jobs with a mortgage and a second baby on the way to go Suntrix full time. And I remember sitting in the car park of the hospital, going in to have my second child and frantically making phone calls to order stock before I went offline. True story. I remember living off of our credit card for months, and I remember being grateful that our kids were too young to understand why they weren't getting Christmas presents. And I remember Dave and I working late at night, as usual, in tears, going, I don't want this. This is too hard. This isn't what I was expecting. And I remember getting up the next day and going to work and doing that every day for another year before things got easier. And it was a hard time. There were sleepless nights, there were mistakes, there were sacrifices, there were very hard decisions. But it did get easier, and this is not a story of hardship and pain. This is a good story. We had a lot of fun. We met some amazing people, and we've grown so much as individuals, as part of this experience. So it was a real surreal journey, one that I look back at and I'm really amazed at what we've achieved. And it's with a real sense of pride that we both stand up here in front of you tonight. A librarian and a network engineer with no previous business experience, just a vision and a passion and a whole heap of pluck. And so that's what I meant about being an accidental entrepreneur. In the beginning, we never set out to create such an amazing business. We grew with it, we learned along the way, we had that persistence and that courage and that passion, and we made it work. I have to say, we never really focused on what we'd achieved. We just did the work. And then, about 12 months ago, we won South Australian Telstra Business of the Year. And, okay, now I'm going to tell you my second secret. After we won that award, and this is a true story, for about a week afterwards, I was just waiting for that phone call from Telstra to say, oh, sorry, we've made a mistake. You need to return the award, you know, and I'd be like, oh, yeah, no, I understand, not a problem. Because we never really considered Suntrix to be anything special, no different to those thousands of other businesses around Australia who were working hard and trying to survive and trying to make a difference. And it's taken these awards for us to realise that we are different and that our skills, our persistence, our hard work has set us apart. And that goes for all of you. So you are special, you have worked hard, and you have what it takes to grab an idea and to run with it. It doesn't matter the size of your company, how long you've been in business, whether you take home another award tonight or not. You have what it takes, and that is something special. So give yourself credit where it's due, be proud of your achievements, and I do want to say thank you to Telstra for organising these awards to showcase some amazing companies around Australia and for recognising that we are different and that our skills and our work should be celebrated. Now, maybe some of you knew that you were going to start a business from the age of five and you've always had that confidence and the faith that you were in the right place. And if that's you, I admire you and I commend you, and that is how I aim to raise my children. But if you're like me, and you still kind of look behind your shoulder every now and then and wonder whether that's Telstra knocking on the door to take those certificates off the wall, then welcome to my club. And just remember that you do deserve to be here, and you are amazing. To have made it to this room, you are one of few, and that's something to be proud of. So I just want to finish with a small piece of advice. All of you, wherever you're sitting right now, I want you to stop. I want you to take a deep breath. I want you to look around and I want you to savour this moment, because this is really special. So don't forget it, enjoy it, don't be nervous, and have a great night. Thank you.